Hallelujah. I need you to understand something today, that Christian life is not a life that criticizes and fights and find faults with people, condemn people, talk against people, backbite people. That is not the Christian life. If you are involved in that, maybe you are still a babe in Christ. You need to grow. And that is why God is sending me to, you know, teach in this direction today, and I believe it's going to bless you. My name is Joseph Adenuga. I'm the pastor of Prevailing Church. I'm here again with the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ to encourage, to motivate, and to inspire you. May God bless you as you listen. Today I pray that God Almighty will open your heart. God will flood you with the anointing of the Holy Spirit. God will increase that anointing of God upon your life in the name of Jesus. And it shall be well with you. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Today I just want to continue on the topic, understanding the Christian life. You see, when you understand who you are as a Christian, you will know how to walk with God. I just want to talk today about the danger of criticizing other Christians, the danger of criticizing pastors and prophets, the danger of looking down on people who are your fellow Christians. You see, a Christian is a member of the family of God. Every family that wants to really stand united. And that's why the Englishman says, united we stand, divided we fall. When you belong to a family where everybody is fighting each other, there can never be progress in that family. Just as you came from a family, and if you're a good man or a woman, you love members of your family, you want it to be well with members of your family. You see, your brothers, your sisters, you love them. You want good opportunities for them. You are praying for them because you want them to succeed in life because they are members of your family. You see, if you become a president or governor, you want to take care of all the members of your family. You want it to be well with them because of you. So why are we fighting each other in Christianity? Every one of us who are Christians belong to the same family. We have the same Father. You see, as we used to sing in those days, that God, Jesus is my brother. The Holy Spirit, the precious Holy Spirit is my guide. The devil is not my relation. You see, when you understand that you belong to that family headed by God, all of us are brothers and sisters. And we need to love one another. When we love one another, we don't criticize, we don't fight. You see, there may be many denominations. There may be Catholic, Baptist, Presbyterian, Anglican, and different kinds of churches on the face of the earth. These churches are just departments of the real church. The real church has no name. The name of the church is Jesus. Jesus is the head of the church. And so the name of the Church of Jesus Christ is Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. There is no division. When God looks at the church, he doesn't see Catholic. He doesn't see Presbyterian. He doesn't see any church that we are fighting for today. You see, the Church of Jesus are the members of Christ, those who have given their lives to Jesus as their Lord and Savior. And we need to understand that we are a family. And because we are a family, we need to stand together. And this is the point where God wants me to really hit and hammer today. If you are a Christian, stop criticizing other Christians. Stop talking against some prophets, some pastors, some evangelists. Because you don't know what is behind them. It is true, the Bible warns us in the book of Matthew 24 that in the last days there will be many false prophets who will come to deceive. But the Bible did not leave us in the dark. The Bible says, by their fruits we shall know them. We know the false prophets by their fruits. That one, there is no doubt about it. So even when we know somebody is a false prophet, we don't need to criticize them. We need to pray for them, because Jesus Christ came to die for sin, for sinners. He came to die for our sins. So even if somebody is a false prophet, instead of criticizing that false prophet, God expects you to pray for that false prophet so that that false prophet can come to the knowledge of Jesus. You see, it's a battle. The Bible says we are not fighting against flesh and blood. You see, it has gotten to a level where some people, they not only fight other pastors and prophets, they pray against them. When your Christianity has led you to the level where you are cursing another pastor, you are cursing another prophet, something is wrong with you. When the Bible says our Lord Jesus Christ commanded us to pray for our enemies, why must you pray against a pastor or a prophet? Something is wrong. When you are praying against a prophet, when you are praying against a pastor, something must be really, really wrong with you somewhere. Because maybe you are not born again. Because if you are a born again child of God, you will love even the sinners. You will want the sinners to be converted. Although we know that false prophets are dangerous, but cursing them, no. We only need to pray for them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you to understand this. You may not like this message at this point, because maybe that is what you do. You may really want to stop hearing this message right now. And if you want to stop hearing this message right now, it's okay. But if you can continue to hear this message, what God sent me to you is that it is not time for you to criticize a pastor or a prophet, because you are not his God. You don't know when God called him. Because some people, you think they are false. When we get to heaven, you may be surprised that they will not only lie in the bosom of Abraham, they will lie in the bosom of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. If somebody is performing miracles, if somebody is opening the blind eyes, if somebody is speaking the name of Jesus and miracles are happening, I don't want you to criticize that person, no matter how you think that person is not of God. If somebody is saying in the name of Jesus and people are getting delivered, if somebody is praying for people in the name of Jesus, the Bible says, this sign shall follow them that believe. In my name, they will cast out devils. They will speak with new tongues. They will take up serpents. They will drink deadly things. It shall not hurt them. If somebody is casting out demons in the name of Jesus, don't criticize him. Because if you criticize him, you don't understand the Christian life. And let me tell you, how many demons have you casted out? How many sick people have you healed? How many blind eyes have you opened? How many cripples have you made to walk? If your answer is zero, you have not made any of them, why must you criticize someone who is doing that? Let me tell you, if you're a pastor, pray for other pastors. Don't fight other pastors. You see, that thing in you that wants you to hate other pastor is definitely not God. It's something else. I'm telling you the truth. You may hate this message. You may even hate me for this. But this is the word of God unto you. God loves you as much as he loves other people. If you think that God loves you, I want you to think again. As he loves you, so does he love me. As he loves you, so does he love the other pastor. So does he love your other brother and sister. Don't hate your sister. Don't hate your brother. Don't fight somebody. You see, if you are a child of God, let's stand together. In every army, any army that is wounded, any army that is a casualty, all the other soldiers rally around to help. Why are we not helping each other in Christianity? This must change. And it must change. The change must start from you. Hallelujah. I believe God has spoken to you today. The Christian life is a caring life. The Christian life is a loving life. The Christian life is a life that speaks the word of God. The Christian life is a life of authority. The Christian life is a life of victory. The Christian life is a life of unity with other Christians. I hope you have heard. May the Lord bless you today for listening to this. I'd like you to rebroadcast this. Get people aware that they need to love one another. God is love. Hallelujah. The Bible says that anyone that hates his brother is abiding in darkness even until now. Hallelujah. It is well with you. So thank you so much. Once again, this is Joseph Adenuga, the pastor of Prevailing Church, signing out and saying, be blessed and remain blessed.